ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಮೈ ನೇಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀವತ್ಸ. ಐ ಎಮ್ ಎ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಯೂರೋ ಆಂಕಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಎಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್. ಟುಡೇ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್. ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅವೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಕಾಮನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ಡೆಕೇಡ್ಸ್. It is unfortunate that many people do not even realize or understand that there is an organ called prostate. Prostate is an organ seen only in men. It is required for the purposes of fertility. It is situated below the urinary bladder. And the normal phenomena of prostate gland evolution or resolution is that over a period of time, as the person ages, prostate gland enlarges in size. It is not uncommon to find close to 80% of men aged 60 and above having a prostatic enlargement. By default, prostatic enlargement in itself does not mean that a person is having malignancy or cancer. However, the converse is also true, that just because we understand that prostate gland has a natural tendency to enlarge with age, it is always not benign or not cancerous. So any man with a prostate enlargement should reach out to a urologist who will examine and then determine whether it is safe for the person to be not evaluated further to rule out cancer. So coming back to the etiology or the most common causes of this cancer, age in itself, advancing age in itself, is attributed to be one of the causes for the prostate cancer. The other common causes of prostate cancer are consumption of tobacco in any form, that is, it could be smoking, it could be usage of paan, gutka, jarda, snuff, any form of tobacco consumption. Obesity, that is, being overweight with a BMI of more than 30, is also attributed to be a cause of prostate cancer. Consumption of red meat in excess is also considered to be a cause of prostate cancer. So historically, if you look at the etiology of prostate cancer has been the commonest form of solid organ malignancy all over the Western world. It was considered to be very infrequent or rare in the Indian subcontinent, but things have unfortunately changed in the last two decades with more and more urbanization or modernization, and more and more utilization of industrial activity, industrial chemicals, chemicals in agricultural activity. Prostate cancer, unfortunately, is also now becoming more and more common in India. So it is important for people to be aware of this gland and aware of the possibilities of prostate cancer. The trick or the challenge in managing these prostate gland disorders is that the symptoms of prostate cancer are similar to the symptoms of a benign prostatic enlargement or a non-cancerous prostatic enlargement. So most of the times, men with prostate enlargement present with urinary disturbances like increased frequency of urination, meaning to say having to pass urine repeatedly, urgency, meaning to say that there is a strong sense of urgency to pass urine, failing which the person will have a feeling or anxiety that he might leak urine even before reaching the restroom, which can also happen at times and which is called as urge incontinence. There can be a few small subset of patients who will have hesitancy, meaning to say they cannot initiate urination as soon as they reach the restroom. They have an urge to pass urine, but when they are ready to pass urine, the urine doesn't flow out immediately. This is called hesitancy. Intermittency or interrupted voiding, meaning to say that the urinary flow will not be achieved or will not be successful in one go, that is, the flow will be interrupted several times before the person feels that he has emptied the bladder. At times there is a possibility that patients feel that even after the urinary flow has stopped, that some amount of residual urine is still remaining in their bladder. This is called as incomplete sense of emptying, or very commonly having to get up at night to pass urine. So these are the constellation of urinary symptoms which occur with prostatic enlargement. A vast majority of men having these symptoms will not have prostate cancer. They will just have a benign enlargement of the prostate gland. However, whenever there is even one of these symptoms, it is important for the person to reach out to the doctor without any hesitation or taboo, get himself evaluated to make sure that we are not dealing with prostate cancer in that particular situation. Diagnosis of prostate cancer is very easy. It requires a patient to report to a urologist who will do a simple rectal examination. Prostate gland can be accessed through the rectum, can be felt through the rectum, so it is very easy to examine this gland. The vast majority of the times, a bare examination of the gland will tell the doctor whether we are dealing with cancer or not. Whenever there is a doubt, the doctor can ask for a simple blood test, very inexpensive, a small ultrasound scan of the abdomen and pelvis, and within these 2-3 maneuvers, prostate cancer can be identified in a vast majority of patients. Whenever there is a doubt, the doctor will ask for a prostate biopsy, again which is very easy to do, and in more than 97-98% of the patients, a constellation of these tests will rule out prostate cancer certainly. When you look at cancer, most of the times the first impression is that the you see the end of the road, that there is a potential threat to life and there is a potential threat to the quality of life, meaning to say that now that a patient is diagnosed with cancer, a lot of treatments will be done. Most of these treatments are complicated with lot of side effects and which will cripple a person or make the person, you know, confined to the house or even confined to the bed. I would like to take this opportunity to debunk this common myth. I would like to say that in the vast majority of cancers, treatment is good. Most of the times, quality of life is retained or kept very intact, and in certain situations even enhanced. This is even more true in the case of prostate cancer management, because typically prostate cancers are very slow growing and compatible with successful treatment. So when identified appropriately and treatment is delivered appropriately, a vast majority of these patients can be cured. Even in advanced stages of prostate cancer, when we talk of advanced stages, I mean to say stage 3 or stage 4 of prostate cancer, treatment is very good for even these stages of disease. And even when we cannot cure patients of prostate cancer, with minimum treatments which are not too taxing on the patient's quality of life, the disease can be managed for several years. So that is another important advantage that a patient of prostate cancer will have. So there should not be any hesitancy whatsoever in the minds of people to reach out to the doctor and take care. Coming to potential ways that we can prevent prostate cancer. Most cancers are somatic in nature, meaning to say they are not hereditarily acquired. But there is always a small element of risk of hereditary transmission, and even in prostate cancer it is the same. Close to about 7-10% of all prostate cancers can be transmitted through heredity. Heredity does not necessarily mean that the father of the patient should have had the disease. Heredity can also span over several generations, meaning to say that the patient's grandfather or the maternal uncle or maybe one of the siblings of his father might have had prostate cancer. Most of the times we encounter people saying that prostate cancer was not seen in our family. But up until the last 20 years, it was even difficult to understand what kind of problems the patient had. A vast majority of men who would be old would encounter urinary difficulties, would never reach out to the doctor because of the taboo involved with the problem, and then simply die. And most of these deaths would have been attributed for old age. So we should always be mindful that there is a small risk that this disease can run in heredity. Not only does prostate cancer have an association with prostate cancer in the other male members of the family lineage, Prostate cancers can also be associated with breast cancers, ovarian cancers, and colonic cancers. So there is a small percentage of patients, like I mentioned, 7 to 10% of patients who can have prostate cancer if one of these cancers have been found in the family. So one of the key components of prevention is if any such history or any such event is there in the family known to us, it is important for us to go and get ourselves screened. Screening is very easy. They will just do a simple blood test called prostate specific antigen or PSA, and this in most of the instances can guide the doctor of whether further evaluation is required or not. So screening can be started in a patient with a family history of cancer once the man turns 40, at an interval of every 3 to 5 years, and after the man turns 50, at an interval of once in 2 years, and once in a year once the man turns 60. The other preventive measures that one can take as such to minimize the risk of prostate cancer is to avoid tobacco in all forms, to minimize the consumption of red meat, to moderate the consumption of alcohol, and to maintain a healthy body mass index, that is to have a healthy physical activity to maintain the weight in the desired range. So doing all these can definitely minimize the risk of having prostate cancer. I hope this piece of information was useful to you. You can leave a question in case there is any, which we can try to address at a later date. Thank you very much.